In Bangladesh, authorities have begun easing internet restrictions and a curfew imposed after student-led protests over state job quotas led to mass unrest. Soldiers are still deployed in large numbers on the country's streets, including in the capital, Dhaka, the scene of some of the worst violence. The government has accepted a court ruling largely scrapping the hated quota system as demanded by protesters. But students have threatened to resume demonstrations if the government doesn't quickly ease restrictions. DW's Binish Javid is following the developments in Bangladesh for us and joins us now on the set. Binish, where do things stand today?
Michael, things are a bit calm now, but telecommunication services are still limited. Internet connection is also limited, and also internet connectivity is quite slow. But overall, things appear to be calm since Sunday, when the Supreme Court of the country scaled back the job quota, government job quotas. That was one of the main things that had triggered the protests. What we know so far is that social media also remains suspended, but curfew has been relaxed for a couple of hours. But things may appear to be a bit normal now, but it's a country that's grieving loss of a lot of people and a lot of violence.
Binish, a lot of people are talking about that violence, and the one question they want to know is, how did this protest turn so violent?
Michael, more than 150 people have been killed in these protests, and most of them have been students. What rights groups say is that these protests started largely peacefully, but then there was a hard crackdown by Bangladeshi police, by Rapid Action Battalion, by border guards, and the students retaliated. They fought back, and that got things really escalated. There are now students' testimonies that we see. For example, some students have spoken to BBC Bangla, and they have described and explained that they were protesting. Most of the protests were peaceful. And then the police started firing rubber bullets at them. Doctors have told that they received an overwhelming number of patients with gunshot wounds. I'm talking about when there was a peak of clashes. We actually also spoke to one of the protesters in Bangladesh who was injured. And Michael, I have to tell that the internet connectivity and the telecommunication service was largely blocked, so it was very difficult to communicate with the student. So we hear a very garbled voice. Let's see what this protester had to tell us.
Sure.
My question is, yes. So, the thing that
So, Michael, we can't really understand what he's saying.
Extremely difficult.
So it was with a lot of tries, we figured out, and I was speaking with a Bangladeshi student here, and both of us tried to understand what he was saying. So basically, he's a 24-year-old student. Mm-hmm. On 17th July, he was protesting with other students, and then he was hit by rubber bullets on his left arm. So he says that the police started firing rubber bullets, and then when they ran, he was hit on his back by members of Bangladesh Chhatra League, which is a pro-government student body. The members of that body started hitting him with bricks and sticks. Bangladesh Chhatra League is also accused. Amnesty International says that they have received testimonies of eyewitnesses and students who say that the members of this group attack students at Dhaka University without discriminating between male and female students. Michael, the government denies being behind the violence. They say they blame the opposition for instigating the protesters, but rights groups and many, many protesters largely blame the government of Bangladesh of being behind this crackdown.
Binish, we only have half a minute, literally, but I do want to ask you this. The student protesters have given an ultimatum to the government for certain conditions. What exactly do they want?
They basically want Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina to apologize for what has happened. They also want her to accept responsibility for what they call mass killing of the students. They also want Bangladesh Chhatra League, the pro-government student body, to be banned from student politics. The government says that they have set up an investigative committee that will investigate the killings, but many students, many people in Bangladesh are very angry and do not trust that this investigation would be independent.
That's a DW's Binish Javid. Many thanks, Binish.